All right, now, yesterday I had a dream. A dream that revealed that I was in a spiritual court after I trespassed or after I went to the mountain of ancestors, the mountain called Modimolle with a camera, and I captured things that I was not supposed to capture on my video camera. And the landlord was not happy about it. So there's been a court session from Monday night, Tuesday night, and on Wednesday night yesterday, that's when I got the verdict. I didn't know I was in court until I saw the vision or the dream last night. And today, I woke up early in the morning and I put 2 plus 2 together and I realized that actually, I was in a serious trouble for traveling to the mountain of ancestors with the camera. Everybody knows that it is not easy to go and climb Mountain Modimolle and still act like a journalist. I saw so many things on this mountain, and I want you to relax because it's gonna be a long ride. We might have in 1 hour video, which can be divided into three parts, but it will worth your time. Remember, this is not based on the studies. This is not based on the book you read from your favorite author telling you about history. This is not based on the rumors that somebody had from other people, and that somebody is coming here to tell you about the rumors. This is based on what I saw with my own eyes and what I saw when I was sleeping, which we can say the third eye, which is the dream, the language of the ancestors. Some are saying Mountain Modimolle is the forbidden mountain. Others will tell you that normally they will see the old woman on this mountain making sure that she keep order. Others will tell you about the old man. Many people see different things depending on the state of their spiritual space are they in. Others are going to the mountain because they hear people saying the mountain is a powerful mountain and they want to get power. Others are making videos online telling people that if you want stones from Modimolle, I can give you the stones and each stone is 500 rand. And others are saying, if you want to have a marriage, if you want to get this, if you want to be blessed, if you want money, you want this and that, come to me, I can help you with the stones from Modimolle. Then you will see prosperity and things, and they have rules. They will tell you that you bring the stones back after 2 years, and they are going to help you with this and that. There is terms and conditions. I don't know about that, but what I can tell you is that I've been on the mountain. This past Monday, on the 30th of August 2021, I went to the mountain with a camera. I see lately people go there in groups using their cell phones to capture the beauty of Mountain Modimolle. But after I saw this dream, I am shocked. Because of I understand that the landlord it is not happy. Let me share the dream with you. So I'll go back and tell you the whole story, the background story of how I got to Modimolle and what really happened and what I saw on this mountain. Okay, in this dream, I saw my grandmother's house. When I see my grandmother's house, she was still staying in the mud house. That mud house was there during those years when I was 8, when I was 9 or 10. Before the government will start, building the RDP houses for people and stuff. My grandmother was staying in the mud house. And there is this spiritual connection between me and my grandmother. She just passed away this July this year, and on the ID she was 101 101 years of age. But the family members will tell you that she was 120 because of now older people didn't know how to count their years during that time of, you know, the freedom when they wanted to give everybody an ID and she just mentioned the number. And now she is not too old from her first born. So when we look at things, we're like, yes, she is 101, but she is not 101 because of now, you know, her first born has so many years. So there is no way she can have her first born while she was still that young. So that shows that 101, it is not actually her years. She is older than that. But we will stick on the 101. Remember the number 101. So now, and also remember the number 120. So now, I saw that there was a court case which was going on. Like there were like cases which were there, but they didn't interest me a lot until this last case, which they were busy proceeding. They were discussing this case. And I saw this American top star. She is well known. She is respected. She was sitting because of now she is complaining of saying, I remember her exact words when she said, he came to my house, disturbed peace while I was with my children and my family. And now I have to attend this court every day whereby I'm the one who is wronged. I didn't go to him. He came to me. And now I don't have time for this. This amount of money, I almost mentioned the amount because it's almost $1 billion. Almost $1 billion. She said, I will write this check so that we cannot continue anymore with this case. And I will pay this money in a period of 4 years. Like he will get half of this money in 2 years and he will get the remaining in the other 2 years. But I didn't know or I didn't hear the terms and the conditions of the case. Because what I remember of that when she is putting that money forward, normally it comes with the terms and conditions. I'm gonna pay so much, but he is not supposed to do this. He is not supposed to do that. That's normally how it goes. But I didn't hear that part because of after she mentioned the number, I looked at the person who was the lawyer who was representing this other person who I don't even know. And even this lawyer who was representing this person, I don't even know. But remember, the case or the court is at my grandmother's house. My grandmother, she is in the madhouse. And I'm watching everything happening because I am there while they are proceeding with the case. So the man who looks like he's in his late 50s or 60s, he is nodding after the American superstar mentioned the number that she is willing to pay. That means the lawyer agrees with the settlement. And now the judge said, wait, it looks like we have something. What are you saying, miss? That's when she's saying, I'm willing to pay so much in a period of 4 years. And I don't even understand why am I paying simply because of this person came to my space. But she was not happy at all. Now, when I wake up early in the morning, to a place where I stay, there is a big screen where they advertise. And I find out that the person who is on that picture is the same person that I saw on my dreams and that person who was putting this money for a settlement. She is sitting on top of a car on the billboard and next to her, there is a brand, a company that I cannot mention. And that company, she is selling something from the company. It's a clothing line company. She is selling something and she's sitting on top of the car. The picture must be yellowish. It has some yellow colors. And yes, the picture is yellow. I took the picture early in the morning because when I went outside, because my girlfriend was like saying, it is cold outside, you must wear a hat. When I went outside, the first thing that I saw is the billboard, because it is facing exactly to my balcony. Sometimes that billboard, it even, you know, distract us when it comes to sleeping. But me, I sleep with the light on. My girlfriend always complain about it. She always say, this disco light, you know, they must disconnect it. There is a time around 10 o'clock that they disconnect it, and it will go on again maybe around 5 or maybe 4, I don't know. Around there, it will go on. So I saw her picture on the billboard, and I'm like, there she is. Because I just dreamt about her. And today when I record this, it's Thursday. Yesterday on Wednesday, somebody gave me the machine. You see, like this bicycle machine that people are using in the gym. She was like saying, you know what, this machine is working, but sometimes it stops. I don't know what is the problem of the machine. This machine, it has the name of that clothing line company that I saw in my dreams. And when I wake up early in the morning, that billboard picture, it is that company that has the endorsement with that big celebrity woman from USA. And it really, I look at that and I'm like, there is no way it's coincident. I was just given the machine yesterday for free. And I see this picture, and I just had a dream about this woman saying she will pay so much money. So now I am start asking myself questions. That is she paying because of, am I going to be associated with that brand? Or is she paying because of, there is a court case. First of all, I'm like asking myself, why is she at my grandmother's house? Not the way things are looking right now, because we renovated, you know, there is buildings now, there is stuff which were not there before, the mud house. Why is it coming as, you know, a picture whereby is the elders who are discussing that? And lately, I'm having so many dreams whereby I'm seeing people from my family members that I've never seen before, that I was just prophesied about, that I heard about. A day before I climbed Modimolle Mountain, I saw a dream. And in this dream, it was me and all the grandchildren of my late grandmother. And we were all sitting, we were eating pap, mashed potatoes, and mopane worms. We were all happy, and I don't know what is the meaning of mopane worms, what is the meaning of the mashed potato and also pap, because the same dream of pap and mashed potatoes but without mopane worms, I saw it also when I was going to be accepted for the YouTube partner program, because I had a dream, and in this dream I was sitting with my mom and the other family member. We were sitting down and mom brought pap and mashed potato, and I sat down and I ate, and we were all happy. We didn't say anything. She just served us food and we sat down and we ate. And after that, that's when I will just receive the notification or the email that saying, congratulations, you've been accepted to YPP, whatever. And she didn't say much. And remember, my mom, she's late also. And yeah, not to go deep into details, this dream of pap and mashed potatoes is coming twice, and with people who are very close to me, people who are late. But now the connection with me and my grandmother, the late grandmother, it was that even before when she was still on earth, I was still connecting with her. If there was something bad that was going to happen, I knew that she would come into my dreams and tell me, and I'll know that, okay, she told me that I shouldn't do this, I shouldn't do that. Even when it comes to food, in most cases, when I go to caves, when I go to the river or this and that, I just dream the way I see myself eating, like pap and something, or pap and fish, if I may be more specific. And I will make sure that I have to go to the market or go to a space or a shop where I can buy that fish and cook the dish that I saw in my dreams that I'm supposed to eat, then I'll eat that dish before I go to the mountain or before I go to the river. It has always been like that. Whatever they're showing me is either is the white beans, is either is the sugar beans, is either is morocco, the spinach and stuff. I always do that. It's either I see, you know, the peanuts or the nuts or stuff, I'll go and buy them and make sure that before I go there, I eat them before I go there. That's how I've been doing my things. Because I just want to be deep on this video whereby I can say some of the things that people who think I am just creating videos and I'm sharing a lot of personal stuff and I'm sharing a lot of ancestral stuff on this channel or I'm sharing a lot of family stuff, think again, because we are only on the foundation. We are only on the foundation. There is a 5-year plan. You will see. Now, let's go back from the beginning, how I got myself on this mountain at the first place. All right, my younger sister had a dream and she saw me drowning in the ocean and she saw me going head first. I was not fighting and it looks like something was pulling me down. She called me, she told me about the dream. It bothered me some couple of days. One day there was this woman who was delivering stuff. She was just driving a car and she was lost. She came to my workspace and she spoke with me and she needed direction. I gave her direction. I said, before I forget, Mama, can I ask you one question? She said, yes, you can ask. I asked her a question of saying, my sister, she had a dream and she saw me drowning in the ocean, but I was going head first. What does it mean? Then that conversation, that one question became a conversation which was like an hour long, and she told me so many things and she said, but what you need to do is to buy candles and light those candles, you know, every night before you sleep for 3 days, and you know, so that you can see where is the problem between your two family members, like the family from your father's side and your mother's side, because it's clearly showing that one of your ancestral family side, it is not happy with you. So when you light the two candles, be careful, look at which one burns until the end and which one doesn't burn. If they both burn until they're all, you know, there is nothing left, that means your ancestors from both sides, they don't have a problem. There is no problem of a same name, no problem of a name. Everything is fine. You just have to do things that you know you need to do. And she told me that, and she said, one more thing that I can tell you is that you are selfish. Ever since you got the job, you never said thank you to your ancestors. Remember that. Okay, fine, I buy candles and I light candles for 3 days, and I had, you know, a dream on the second day, and on this dream on the second day I saw myself climbing the stairs, but these stairs are going round. They are going round when I'm like going up. So I realized that the stairs is a symbol of a mountain, and the mountain that I know is round is Modimolle Mountain. And Modimolle Mountain has been coming over and over in my dreams. I had dreams whereby I see myself in a taxi and somebody is asking me, are you going to Modimolle Mountain? I'm like, yes. And they say, but are you ready? I used to say I am not ready in my dreams, but I am going there because I am supposed to go there. Because there was a space whereby even if when I meet people, you know, on the street, when they talk to me, they're just telling me that there is nothing more we can tell you. You know what you need to do. You know what you need to go. Your ancestors are waiting for you at Modimolle Mountain. You must go to Modimolle Mountain. So it was a calling. I was supposed to go there, but I didn't know what I was going to do when I get there. When I arrived there, it was just to pray. And after praying, I didn't have much to do. That's where I went with the camera and I recorded some videos. And clearly those videos, you know, they didn't, you know, sit well with the landlords on that mountain. But I'm going to share everything with you guys so that you'll understand where I am. 2 days before I will take a trip to Modimolle, I had this dream. And in this dream, I was making a cup of tea. And I realized that there was someone next to me that I don't know who was with me making a cup of tea with me. And I've noticed something about that person because of he is in his early 40s. Need. And he is one of those people who didn't like to cut their hair. He's one of those people who love to comb their hair. They will be pitch black. And that person was the beard. He made sure that he shaved the beard, but the hair was not cut off. He didn't cut the hair, but he was well shaved. Then that person was making a cup of tea, drinking tea with me. He didn't even say any word. After that, he left the room and I saw him to the other house, which has a big window that that person can see where I was. Like, even if when the person moved from where he was with me after making a cup of tea, he went to the space where he sat in the other apartment, whereby he can still see me. And that dream showed that he is with me, protecting me, and it even shows the importance of libation. Sometimes when you wake up early in the morning, before you drink a tea, you know, you see people doing that, pouring a little on the ground. Before you drink water, pouring a little on the ground. Before you drink cold drink, you know, you pour a little on the ground, you know, for the ancestors, of saying, as I am about to drink this water, you can also drink water. And you wait for some couple of seconds or minute before you drink. Many people will know that, especially Africans. It's called libation, pouring libation or something like that. It is there, it's ancient in Africa. Most people know it. It's not only the traditional people who are doing it. People are doing it who understand the culture. And he really showed why, in most cases, I was told to do that and why I should keep on doing it. And also on that dream, it shows that I am not alone. There is my ancestors who are watching me. So even if I'm about to take the trip to Modimolle, because it's the first time I'm going there, I don't know nothing about the mountain, I shouldn't be afraid because I am not alone. And that person was revealed to me years ago when I was still in Val, whereby there was this other prophet who told me to go and look for my father, who told me that what happened between your mom and your father is none of your business. What you need to do is to go and search for your father, because you are writing books, you are writing films, and nothing will happen because of there is a problem in your ancestral space whereby you need to go and fix. They need to make an African welcome traditional ceremony thing. And I already shared that story because I went to look for my father, who was not even in our lives for many years, and I found him. He was happy, and I shared the whole story on the other video. It's called what's the name of that video? It is into my videos. When I just go and check all the spiritual videos that I'm talking about. And I remember when he prophesied me using water, what he really told me, and he said he see two of my ancestors. He see these two names. He see the name Daniel and the name Albert. And one of the ancestor, he was an outlaw. He didn't want to be controlled. He didn't want to listen to what people were telling him. He wanted to do things his way. He passed away, of course, many years ago. And he still wants to come back on earth. But be careful, because if he will find a way of coming back to you, he will want you to become the outlaw. And there is this other one who doesn't cut his hair. He is very sweet, soft. He doesn't talk much, doesn't do much. But if he is with you, he will protect you. And he will always make sure that he give you good things, but his blessings and everything takes time. And when you receive those things, they are there because they come from the ancestor, which has a light, a good energy. When you pray, remember these two names, and you want the one who doesn't cut the hair. And when I look at you, you were not supposed to cut the hair. You were supposed to leave your hair. But because of you want to do things the way you want to do things, I'm not going to tell you what to do. And I remember when he was holding the cup of water And he said, before he prophesied, look into this water and tell me what you see. And I said, I see water. And he said, look again. And all I can see was water. He said, your time is not, has not arrived yet. But when the time is right, you are going to see what I see. You and I, we are from the same cloth. You and I, we are like the same. That's the reason why I feel comfortable when I share these things with you. Sit down, and we sat down. I remember that day we were eating, you know, pap and sugar beans. And it was an amazing day because people were waiting for that prophet to prophesy them, to give them stuff or maybe things that they're stuck with. But he just chose to give me things, and everybody was listening to what he was prophesying. We were at Val, everybody. We were at Val. Gone are those days. I hear now they're saying it's, you know, they decided to put storage there. It's just something else. You know what? Let me not even touch that issue. I was there during good times. Now, when I see this man, my mind quickly went back to the prophecy that I was told. And when I see him drinking tea with me and sitting to the other apartment watching me, and I was like saying, I'm taking the trip to Modimolle because of I have the right ancestors by my side. I have the right ancestor that can protect me, who shows me that don't be afraid. I am here and I'm here to help you, and I am here to shine a light on you, and your trip will be a success with me. And I think how I connected with him was because of after I was told that I'm selfish and YouTube paid me my first paycheck, and I decided to do what my grandmother taught us, what my mother also taught us, you know, that way of doing things, of saying a first paycheck, it is not your paycheck. You have to share it with your siblings and people who are around. And I bought airtime to everybody. And I also remembered that actually, ever since I got a job, I've never buy anything or do anything for my father. You know, since that ceremony that he did for me, you know, many years ago, I think it's 8 or 9 years ago. And I've never, you know, buy anything, you know, for him. And the reason why maybe is because of he was always feeling guilty of not being in my life for those years. And every time he see me, he wants to be the one who do something for me rather than me doing something for him, because he feels like he owe me for all those years that he was not in my life. And maybe that's one of the reasons why I didn't do that. But the ancestors, you know, they didn't even let that one slide. They were like, you are so selfish. You never even said thank you. And after that, I've never even went to do something. I just go home and I'm like, they see me, I'm home, but I don't do anything, you know. And because of I took that deterrent airtime and I sent my father and I told him that I decided to buy you airtime, he was so happy for me. And for him being that happy, that opened up, you know, everything, because of now days later, that's when I saw this ancestor that I don't even know that I was told about many years ago. Now, because of I did that, I open up some of the good luck and stuff so that when I go to the mountain, I can go there being protected. And now that really showed by doing that, that this ancestor is from my father's side, the one who protected me. And that really means that those who wanted me on that mountain is the ancestors actually from my father's side. Because of I know that my grandfather, he was a great traditional healer many years ago. So I took the trip, guys. I went to Wanderers, you know, taxi rank Joburg, and I got into a taxi straight to Modimolle Mountain. And the taxi was only 280 from that. And I didn't know that there is a gate. I didn't know that, you know, the taxi drivers, they know exactly that there are people who take the, you know, taxis to go straight to Modimolle Mountain. And now I'm about to climb the mountain, and on the next video, I'm going to be sharing the whole journey on top of the mountain, what I saw on top of the mountain, and the time when I was like taking a lot of videos, what was really happening, and the things that really shocked me on top of the mountain. So you can feel free to join me on part 2 of this video. We will have maybe part 3 also, because I just want to make sure that we share stuff so that we will know and understand some of the things that we don't understand. Thank you.